Welcome to BAM Teacher Tech. In this edition, this is a shout out to all the parents out there about how to find and read your MAP growth report for your child. So first step is you got to be in parent view. So when you're in parent view, your screen should look something similar to this. And what I did was I clicked in underneath of documents. So it's right underneath of test history. And what we're going to be looking for is the MAP results PDF. So go ahead and click there. And when you do that, it will open up a PDF document that looks something similar to this. So here we have a lot of data that we're going to take a look at about how to read together. So over here on the right-hand side, you have a box, and it actually lists out all the different grade levels that your child has taken the MAP growth test. So this child has started in third grade and has taken it all the way to fifth grade. So if this is your child's first year taking the MAP growth report, it will just have their year, their grade listed with just fall, winter, and spring. But since I have access to this report with all three, you can actually see the progress that's made in mathematics and the growth that's happened over time. And so here, this child started off in third grade with a 205 RIT score, being in the 87th percentile. So the percentile is a comparison amongst peers. And so in third grade, this child was at the 87th percentile in the fall, but in the winter only grew by a point. So really the growth wasn't there. And you can see the percentile dropped a little bit. And then in the spring, this child grew by 6 points from fall to spring, but the projection was supposed to be 12. And so when we think about growth academically, it's the same way we can think about growth physically. So just as a child gets measured by the doctor at the doctor's office for height and weight, here we have a report that is going to measure their growth in mathematics and reading. And so it's giving us these percentiles, just like you would hear that your child is in the 50th percentile for height and the 80th percentile for weight, or 20th percentile or 99th percentile. So just like the doctors throw around those percentiles, it's the same thing here. So it's just a comparison amongst their peers who've taken the test at the right around the exact same time. And so we can see the progression in the fourth grade and then the progression in the fifth grade. And so what the RIT score is a RIT score is a comparison against the curriculum. And so in elementary school, so it's a comparison of the elementary school curriculum, but in middle school, the math 6+ test and the reading 6+ test that the children have taken really measures where they're at academically from about second or third grade all the way up to sophomore and junior year of high school. And so the students really see that range on the test. So it is okay for students not to know questions on this test. We're not expecting our students to know and understand sophomore and junior year of high school when they've only made it through fifth grade and now they're in sixth grade. And so really this test finds out grade level, but also gives teachers details as far as strengths and weaknesses for their child in the grade level. So you can really see that here when we talk about the RIT score. And so here we have a nice bar chart to the left that really shows the data in a just a different way that some people like. And so here you have the blue bar is the student's actual RIT score. You have an orange bar, which is the district mean, so the district average. And then also this yellowish bar is the average for all the children. In this case, I'm looking at the fourth grade bar. So all the children in fourth grade who have taken this test. And so we can see right underneath of this, you can see mathematics goals performance. So with this, you can see relative strengths and weaknesses. And so really the weak spot for this child is patterns, functions, and algebra. And this is just a weak spot relative to themselves. So if we look down on the PDF document, you can also see reading. So reading has very similar data, except down here underneath reading goals performance, you can see here the three categories are word origin, semantics, and vocabulary acquisition. You have comprehension of literary text, which is fiction text. And you have comprehension of nonfiction text, which is our nonfiction. You also have a Lexile range, so that combines both fiction and nonfiction to figure out reading level. So that really helps our teachers to understand the reading levels of students. but it also gives you all the same data with the bar chart and the percentiles and risk score there. So that's the MAP growth report in a nutshell. So if you have any questions, feel free to email me at william.peterson@lcps.org. You can also find me on Twitter at BamTeacherTech. So thank you for watching this video about how to read the MAP growth reports for parents.